Hey, everybody. You know, there's a lot of things I'm talking about. Material things that I could lose in my life and I wouldn't lose a wink of sleep over it. But that's not the case for the items that are in this box. You see, the items in this box are two of my most valuable sentimental possessions. Now, some of you have been with my channel a long time, and maybe you've seen the series of videos where I sanded and stained and put a gloss coat on this little wooden box. But enough about the box. Let's take a look inside. These pens belong to my grandfather. He passed away when I was 12. My dad inherited these pens. And eventually, the pens came to me. I can still see in my memories these pens in his shirt pocket. Now, because of throat cancer, my grandfather couldn't speak. I have never once heard his voice. If he wanted to communicate, he took one of these pens from his pocket, and from another pocket he would produce a little pad of paper, and he would write down whatever it was that he was wanting to say. My grandfather worked for Parker Pen. These are Parker pens. These were prototypes to my best knowledge. These are the only two like this in existence. Now, what makes these special? Besides their sentimental value to me, is their shape. Because up until then, pens with a triangle see that the grip is a triangle. Triangular pens did not exist, to my knowledge. So my grandfather thought this, it was his idea to make a triangular pen. And these are his prototypes. I don't know what kind of material this is, but as you can see, it's very beautiful. And this one, too, is just as beautiful and is just as triangular. I remember being fascinated by these pens when I was just a boy. After my grandfather passed away, I forgot about these pens over the years. Until they made their way to me. And seeing them for the first time, when they became mine, brought back all of those memories of seeing these pens in my grandfather's pocket. Yes, these are the only two pens like this. Maybe in the entire world, I feel pretty confident in saying this because, like I said, my grandfather invented this concept. These are his prototypes that he made at the Parker Pen Company. So let's take the upper portion of the pen off. Well, some of you pen experts, which I am not a pen expert, can probably just look at this refill and possibly tell how old it is. Now, I cannot say that somewhere along the line my dad did not put a refill in. Let's take a look at this one. This one is definitely older. It says Parker T. Ball Jotter. Now, like I said, I don't know what kind of material this is. Some kind of acrylic or I'm not sure what kind of other Parker pens may have this same finish, or is this possibly the only one? Because I was not quite sure if they used this material on some other models of pens. It's got brass threads. I like the way that sounds. I could do an entire video of just this for ASMR. Let's put the cap, the top on it. And the green one is my favorite of the two. And it also has brass threads. So I guess you could call these pens Jotters. Uses the Jotter refill, and the caps look like very early Jotters. This was before Parker began to use the arrow design on the clip. Now, before I screw this on, going to see if this writes. And it does. Because if it did not, I was going to put a new refill in it because I want to use this pen in my next video, which will be a crossword puzzle video. Now, I cannot say for sure whether my grandfather liked to work crossword puzzles, but I bet he did. And I bet he would be very happy to know that I was using his pen to work a crossword puzzle. This is my grandpa's pen. And it feels very good to hold this pen. See if the other one writes. This is the one that has the very old refill in it. If I wanted to use this pen, I would have to put a new refill in it. But I would not throw away the old one. I would keep it. And when I was finished writing with this pen, I would put the old refill back into it. One of a kind. Or should I say, one of two of a kind. So let me zoom out just a little. And readjust the focus. I would like to know in the comments, which one of these pins do you like? Let's put those back in the box. So these pins are two of the very few items that I possess that belonged to my grandfather. And I truly hope nothing ever happens to these. I will continue to enjoy these until the time comes that it's time for me to give these to my son. At which point he will be in possession of his great-grandfather's pins. And out of all of the items that my grandfather possessed, these two pins may very well be the most personal items that he had. These two pins were how he communicated to all of us. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this.